टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न बीजेटी एज अ एम्पलीफायर, हाउ बीजेटी वर्क एज अ एम्पलीफायर। नाउ एज वी नो बीजेटी दैट इज बाइपोलर जंक्शन ट्रांजिस्टर हैज टू मेन एप्लीकेशन, दैट एज अ स्विच एंड एज अ एम्पलीफायर। हेयर इज सर्किट डायग्राम ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर एज अ एम्पलीफायर और ट्रांजिस्टर एज अ कॉमन एमिटर एम्पलीफायर। कॉमन एमिटर मीन्स दिस एमिटर टर्मिनल, दिस इज बेस एमिटर एंड कलेक्टर। दिस एमिटर टर्मिनल इज कॉमन बिटवीन इनपुट एंड आउटपुट। इनपुट इज गिवन फ्रॉम बेस एंड एमिटर, आउटपुट इज टेकन फ्रॉम कलेक्टर एंड एमिटर। नाउ दिस टाइप ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज पोटेंशियल डिवाइडर सर्किट। देर आर 3-4 बायसिंग टेक्निक्स ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर, सच एज सेल्फ बायस, कलेक्टर टू बेस बायस, एमिटर बायस, एंड दिस पोटेंशियल डिवाइडर बायस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज सेल्फ बायस। सो हेयर रेजिस्टर R1 एंड R2 आर बेस बायसिंग रेजिस्टर। कैपेसिटर C1 इज इनपुट कपलिंग कैपेसिटर। नाउ व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ कैपेसिटर? कैपेसिटर ब्लॉक्स डीसी सिग्नल एंड पासेस ओनली एसी सिग्नल। एज वी आर एम्पलीफाइंग एसी सिग्नल, दिस एसी इनपुट विच इज शोन हेयर, एंड एट द आउटपुट वी आर गेटिंग दिस एम्पलीफाइड वर्जन ऑफ दिस इनपुट सिग्नल। नाउ दिस कैपेसिटर एक्ट एज अ ओपन स्विच फॉर डीसी सिग्नल, इट ओनली पासेस एसी सिग्नल थ्रू इट। नाउ दिस इनपुट वोल्टेज जनरेट्स बेस करंट आईबी, बेस करंट IB which is flows in this direction. Similarly, R1 and R2 are our base biasing resistor, that is potential, that is voltage gate divided across R1 and R2, and the voltage across R2 applied at the input to transistor. Similarly, this resistor RE, emitter resistor, it acts as a emitter feedback resistor. It provides negative feedback so that our operating conditions stabilize. This resistor, it is collector resistor RC, and this C2 which is connected parallel to RE, it is bypass capacitor. That is, whatever the current appears at this emitter, it bypasses to ground, so that at the emitter we are not getting any voltage. As we are taking output across collector and emitter, that is emitter must be at zero potential. To make this emitter ground, what we have done here, we are connecting this capacitor parallel to this emitter resistor, so that the voltage VE, that is emitter voltage, must be zero, or emitter voltage does not appear. Now let us see how this type of setup works, or operation of this type of setup. When input voltage, AC input voltage applied at the base, between base and emitter of transistor, it generates small base current IB. Similarly, from this DC source VCC, we are getting IBQ, that is quiescent point current, which is nothing but DC current. This AC current and DC current gets superimposed at this point and obtained at the base of this transistor in terms of IB. From this waveform, here we can see this AC base current gets superimposed with this DC base current IB. When AC and DC get superimposed, our AC shifted from this zero level. Here is our zero level. And this AC gets shifted from this zero level. That is, our AC now revolves. Here we can see our AC signal now revolves around this DC base current. Now this signal gets amplified and obtain IC current, collector current IC, as IC is nothing but beta into IB, where beta is current gain in terms of 100 to 150, and IB is our base current. Now this IB gets amplified and obtained at collector in terms of IC. Here we can see this IC, that is amplified version of this IB and IBQ. IB and IBQ, that is AC and DC, obtained at collector in terms of IC and ICQ. Here we can see. Now, this current IC also produces voltage drop across this collector resistor RC, which is given by VRC. Here we can see this VRC. This amplified current produces voltage drop across collector resistor, which is given by VRC. It's nothing but IC into RC. Here we can see this IC into RC, that is VRC, that is voltage drop across this resistor. At the output, we are getting output voltage VCE. Now, as our emitter is at zero potential, output can also be denoted by VC, which is given by VCC minus IC into RC. At the output, we are getting this VCC, that is voltage applied at this terminal, we are getting at the output. But the voltage drop across this resistor gets subtracted from this VCC. From waveform, here we can see at the collector, we are getting VC is equal to VCC minus IC into RC, that is VCC minus IC into RC. Now, as this IC into RC increases, our collector to emitter voltage, or you can say collector voltage, reduces. If value of this IC is high, VC definitely be low. If value of this IC is low, VC increases. IC decreases, VC increases. IC increases, VC decreases. As this VCC is constant. This way, what happens? This amplified current produces voltage, output voltage, which is 180 degree phase shifted with input. Output signal which is 180 degree phase shifted with input. Here we can see from this diagram. If IC increases, ICRC also increases. ICRC increases, VC decreases. As IC, VCC is constant. That is, if IC increase, this ICRC term must be high. If this term is low, this term becomes high, as our VCC is constant. This way, what we are getting? We are getting phase shifted version at the output terminal. Finally, now here we can see this output voltage is also DC shifted with some value, as there is DC is added in this signal. Now, to remove this DC, what we have to do? We just have to connect this another one coupling capacitor at this output terminal. If we connect another coupling capacitor at the output terminal, this DC also gets blocked, and our original, or you can say our AC with no DC obtained at the output, that is DC level reduced to zero, and now we are getting our amplified signal which is revolving around this ground potential or zero potential. This is the working of our transistor as an amplifier, or BJT as an amplifier.